your road to success will and must start with a dream. And this is what I do whenever I get an opportunity to talk to youngsters, talk to the new talent. The only thing I think of doing is to motivate them. And motivation is what is required. Dream of anything you want in life, anything you want from the world. And I have no doubt that you will get it. But while you're doing this, while you're dreaming, just remember, success is not an accident. Dream does not become a reality just by magic. It requires hard work, determination, and perseverance. And as they say, dictionary is the only place where success comes before work. How many of you, of the young chartered accountant, have you read the book Think and Grow Rich? Have you read the book? Any show of hands here? If you have not, keep that book as your bedside reading. This book was written in 1937 by Napoleon Hill. And the title basically a little bit misnomer here. Actually what it talks about, it gives you countless stories of real people who succeeded in life, who worked hard, and who showed faith in what they believed in, faith in their dreams. One such story relates to, this was a time of early 20th century, sometime in 1905. You all must have heard the name of Thomas Alva Edison. There was this gentleman, Mr. Edwin C. Barnes. This Thomas Alva Edison lived in Orange County, New Jersey. And this Edwin Barnes lived too far away from Thomas Alva Edison. Barnes has heard a lot of stories about the new inventions of Mr. Edison. And he dreamt of becoming his business partner. But he had two difficulties. One is he didn't know Edison. And number two, he lived too far away from Edison, from the Orange County. And he did not have money to pay for the railway fare to reach that place. He surmounted those difficulties, got his money from somewhere, and he went to Mr. Edison. And he told him that, he didn't tell him that I want to work for you. He told him that I want to work with you as your business partner. Now, Edison was a very busy man. He said, don't waste my time, go away. He insisted. And after 30 years, Mr. Edison, when he talked about Barnes, his statement was, and I quote, he stood there before me, looking like an ordinary tramp, but there was something in the expression of his face which conveyed the impression that he was determined to get what he had come after. Mr. Edison decided to, he said, no, I cannot make you a business partner. I don't need a business partner, but you can stay. You can work with me if you want. And he agreed. Mr. Edison gave him some very unimportant jobs, but he accepted everything just to be around and close to Mr. Edison. Many, many months passed and nothing happened. No opportunity, but he was focused. He had dreamed of becoming business partner to Edison, and he was focused on that. After a couple of years, maybe, Mr. Edison had perfected a new office device known at that time as Edison Dictating Machine. And none of his salespeople were willing to agree that this dictating machine has some business potential. They said it's difficult to sell. That was the opportunity Mr. Barnes was waiting for. He jumped to that opportunity and he offered his services to Edison and he said, I can sell this machine. Edison said, fine, because no other salesperson was willing to sell it. And he worked hard and he sold this machine. It was so successful, Edison gave him the contract, the national price for that machine. Later on, it went to be called, that machine was stamped as made by Edison and installed by Barnes. And he became business partner after that, Mr. Edison. And he made millions and millions of dollars out of that business arrangement with Mr. Edison. It's not making money, it's not about making money. It's about dreaming, and it's about perseverance, and it's about your faith that you will realize those dreams. So all of you young people, I can only say that sky is the limit. Dream of anything, anything you want in life, and human beings are capable of achieving whatever you want. So with this, I congratulate all of you once again, wish you outstanding success in whatever you want for from life, whatever you dream from. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Malik sir. I would request you to please be here so that we can distribute a couple of more certificates. Next we have is Mr. Shiraz, Muhammad Shiraz. Shiraz is manager at ENY and started off his career in 2013. He wants to earn crazy money and loves traveling. Next we have is Mr. Sayed Awais Tariq. Awais is manager treasury risk at Standard Chartered Bank. He began in 2011 and has a simple but a profound rule for his life. Always improve in life in every day. Please give a big applause for our young, shining, bright stars. Next we have is Osama Khan. Osama is not here, but his mother is here. So she will collect certificate on behalf of Osama. Next we have is Bilal. Bilal has an aspiration to educate, to dedicate himself to the growth of Islamic finance industry. He wants to focus more on digitalization and innovation opportunities of the industry. Congratulations, Bilal. Next we have is Osama bin Ali. Osama started off in 2011 and is AM Assurance at Ferguson. Besides professional engagement, he loves traveling and trekking. Next we have is Saud Amin. Saud is manager accounts at Crescent Steel. He's a fast track student clearing module A and B in first go. He possesses great management skills and he was able to continue playing football while doing CA. Next we have is Syed Basit Ali. Basit is a supervisory senior at KPMG and started off in 2011. He draws his biggest support from his parents. Next we have is Hasband. Hasband began in 2011. He is a supervisory senior at Ferguson. And he aims to become a partner in one of the big four firms. Next we have is Mr. Rahil Merchant. Rahil began his journey in 2011. Within a span of 6 years, he has achieved his qualification. Next we have is Syed Ehsan Ali. Ehsan started in 2011 as now is an AM transition advisory at Ferguson. Also leave a strong legacy and a great impact for our country. Next we have is Ahmad Mustaqim. Ahmad is AM KPMG. He's a high achiever and also began teaching to support his education. He's fond of reading books and has been associated with numerous blood donation camps. Next we have is Awais Khan. Awais is supervisory senior at Ferguson's. He started off in 2011, and throughout his journey, his father had been a source of motivation for him. Please give a big round of applause for Awais. Now next we have is Tala Hussain. Tala is senior associate at KPMG Qatar. His vision is to bring an impact by promoting the cause of education in our country. Next we have is Abdul Hafiz. Abdul Hafiz is AM Ferguson. His parents had been his biggest motivation. Next we have is Mustafa Suhail. Next we have is Mr. Uzair. Next we have is Ms. Rida Fatima Haider. She is not here, probably, and his brother will come and receive her certificate. His brother himself is a chartered accountant, I know him. Now next we have is Zubair Ahmed. Next we have is Mahvish Aslam. Mahvish, please come forward. Next we have is Mr. Danish. Danish is working as a senior at ENY and began his struggle in 2011. He's aimed to be an assurance partner at a Big Four firm, and as well as he wishes to be the president of ICAP in future as well. Thank you very much. Now next we have is Shazim. Shazim is working with ENY and started off his journey in 2012. Earlier he has also secured one gold medal in an FAR2. Financial reporting. Next we have is Mr. Muzammil. Thank you very much, Malik sir, for honoring the occasion and for your kind and wise words for our young members. Now next we have is another member of Southern Regional Committee. He has been elected second time for the regional committee, Mr. Zulfikar Akhtar. He's also a partner in at Ferguson's. Please come forward for honoring the occasion to distribute a couple of more certificates. Now next we have is Mr. Ehsan Tirmizi. Next we have is Shabir Chauhan. Shabir is a supervisor at KPMG who began his journey 9 years ago. He's a brave man who has worked in Afghanistan as well, despite very uncertain security situations. Next we have is Hasnan Hirji. Hasnan is AM planning at Colgate Palmolive. His dream is to start and build a local automotive brand that would manufacture and sell high quality and low cost cars. Next we have is Usama Jameel. Usama is manager finance at Abbott Labs. He is one of the youngest global ACC affiliates qualifying at the age of 18 years, securing nationwide position and highest marks. Next we have is Ms. Tuba Wasim. Tuba is an audit senior. She has secured a position in Metric as well. He wants to be an inspiration for all young girls out there who are afraid to pursue their dreams. Next we have is Yasir. Yasir is an audit senior at ENY and began his journey in 2012. He wants to be a role model for youngsters and he wants to inspire them to not remain content. Next we have is Prem Kumar. Prem is an audit senior at ENY who began his struggle in 2012.